These are the perfect gift for runners. Headphones that go on your bone, not in your ear, so you can hear the cars. I've been running this morning. I've been running away. That's what you do, you run away. This morning, this morning till this afternoon, it's taken me until 3 o'clock to clear my university inbox. And so I'm grateful to the university, to the people who've been replying to my messages and experiencing, unbeknownst to them, my communication differences as an autistic person as I try and solve the problems that I'm having, and they can't help me because they can't see that difference, but they've been very patient with me. And I know of other organisations where when you request reasonable adjustments, you're services are no longer required, so I'm grateful that they persist with patience with me, and I'm grateful for the support of my supervisors who work to understand the barriers I face, and I'm grateful for the wider community at the Centre for Research and Inclusion who actively seek to find out how to make these adjustments. But at the start of the PhD, I said to people, I think it's like a marathon experience and I just have to keep going. And at the moment, I'm in some sort of, not the wall, but something close. And I'm just trying to keep going. I haven't got capacity to work out how to solve the problems. I just have to work through them. And I run rurally, which on edgy on roads, and everybody who's passed me today, so many people have indicated around me and slowed down for me, and I'm so grateful for them for keeping me safe as I run to keep me sane. Like, it's a community effort, and I look at them and I think, I'm running to run away, and I'm running to try and find the body that I need to bring into the field. And it's a body that I disassociate from often, and then that ties back because as an autistic woman I'm at a much higher risk of sexual assault than a non-autistic woman, and at much higher risk of abuse. And so there are reasons for that disconnect. But when I think of those moments, I can also find gratitude there, because the people who protected me, the people who rescued me, the people who offered to hunt them down and get them back, not that I took them up on that offer, were boys too. And I sat there and I said to my husband, all I've managed to do today is clear my inbox. And he said, that's enough. And you have these voices from outside, and these strangers who drive around you on roads, and there is so much to be grateful for. And then you hear people being grateful, and you think, it's a really good way to prop yourself up, being grateful. And it's often practiced by people who need to prop themselves up. It's very muddled. But I ran away and I got back on time, and then I just have to have a shower and then maybe make some chocolate.